Hi everyone, welcome back. So here in this video, we are going to learn how we can create our first application using Anypoint Studio, and then how we can test that application and how we can deploy that application to the on-premise localhost server. So in our earlier video, we saw how we can download and install Anypoint Studio. If you have not downloaded and installed Anypoint Studio yet, so you can go to my blog. I have already posted a blog for that, from where you can get each and every information about how you can install Anypoint Studio in your system, in your different operating system, either it is Windows operating system, or it is Mac OS, or it is Linux OS. So this is a link where you can go to and you can download and configure Anypoint Studio. So after you have downloaded and configured Anypoint Studio, you just need to open your own Anypoint Studio, and here in this tutorial we are going to use Mulesoft Anypoint 7.3 and Mule runtime will be 4.2. So to create a project, open your Anypoint Studio, click on file and new, and then Mule project, and here you can give, let's say that we are, I'll just name it as demo API project, and here you will see, if you see that runtime, it is 4.2, and if you want to install more runtimes, you can just click on install runtime, and here you will get whatever runtimes you wanted to install. So I don't want to install any as of now, and you just need to click on finish. Once you will click on finish, it will open. So here if you see in the right side, we have three components available that we can use while we are developing our application, and here in the bottom, if you see, this is a console, and here we will see the properties of our all components that we will put here, and in this problem section we will see what is the error for a particular project, and this is a project explorer where we can get what is the JRE we have, and we have HTTP servers, we have Mule server, we have sockets, we have all those folders that we need, we have Mulesoft unit test. So all this is a project explorer, this is a canvas where we will design our application. On the bottom left, on the right hand side, we can get all the free connectors, all the free components that are available that we can use, and a few of them we will be using in this tutorial, and here we will get what are all the API consoles that we will be working on. So as in our first video, we discussed about that Mulesoft provides, Mulesoft uses the API led connectivity. That means we are designing API at a different level. It might be system API, or it can be process API, or it can be experience API that we can provide to our developer, and developer can use those API to develop a particular project. So here in this video, what we are going to do is we will discuss how we can create an API, that we can also say how we can create a Mule project. So as we discuss, API always listen a particular URL. API always listen a particular URL where you need to hit, and that particular listener will listen. So first step will be putting a listener here. So for putting a listener here, if you see here in this HTTP, you will select, we have HTTP listener, we have request, basic security filters for loading some static resources. So as of now, we are going to use listener. So what you need to do is just drag and drop that listener, and here you will see. So if you remember that our previous video, we talked about Mule event, Mule message. So Mule event always starts with a trigger. So this is a trigger that is a listener, either it can be a particular URL, or we are it can be a particular trigger what we are triggering, it can be a change data capture, or it can be a platform event if you're talking about Salesforce, it can be a push topic, so anything it can be. So first thing, if you after drag and drop, you will see that we have here the flow name, and here this is a, if you see, if you remove this, let's first remove this. So if you see, we have a source here. Source is a particular starting point for a particular project or particular API. So we have to drag and drop a source here. Let's say that if you wanted to put some other thing, let's say that we have a component called set payload. If you want it drag and drop here, we will not be able to. If you see, we are getting a disabled sign. We cannot, because here we can only put those components that are able to listen a particular endpoint. Let's say that if you talk about Salesforce, so if we say that Salesforce, and if we say subscribe topic, and if you will drag and here, we are able to put here, and we can drag and drop here. So this is why we need to put a listener here in the source, from which source is responsible for executing this particular project of this particular API. So this is why we will be using here a listener here, and after putting a listener here, we have to configure what particular port, what particular host we are looking for, and what is the endpoint that particular API, that particular project will be listening. So if you see that we are getting a red color, so what we need to do is, first we need to configure a connector for this. So just click on plus sign, and here you can say that we'll say that get host demo. As I'm using this particular port, so I'll just put it as 4x9 and leave this base path addresses, and just click on test connection, so that we can be sure our particular local host is listening on particular port that we are trying to provide here. And if this particular we will get a success message here. After that, we will provide some path. So as this is a particular listener, we haven't given which particular URL a particular listener needs to listen. So in other terms, let's understand like this. So let's say that we have different actors here. This is the actor one who need to call. If you say this they are here in this right side, we have multiple actors. It might be A, it might be B, or it might be any other anything can be named for this particular these actors. So this particular actor needs to reference, this particular actor needs to call one of these actors. So let's say that we have a particular medium, we have a listener who is listening, but unless we are not providing which particular endpoint, which particular person you need to call. So let's say that they have 5, and this particular actor is saying that hello. But in this case, you will not be these out of these 5 actors, no one will understand whom this particular person is referring. So in that case, this particular person you need to define a name here, or define a particular unique identity, whatever all these persons are carrying. So here, if it is saying that hello A, so whatever the person who is whose name is A will immediately respond as yes, tell me. So this is how it's going to be. Okay, we are getting similar. So let's make it as 8081 as well. Why we are getting a tooling instance is not available, and we will test it again. Okay, so let's provide a path here. So this is what we have given a port for the listener, and we are not able to somehow test the connection because of the error is coming. We will test if that particular port is listening after deploying. If not, then we will change the port. Just let's delete this, and then once put the listener here again. This is how we are getting, why we are getting here. If you go here in the global elements, you will get that. So let's delete this first. Come here. Now click on add this particular, we will say listener. Okay, let's leave it as it is. We are not able to listen. Provide a here, so let's say that SFDC, or let's say that Mulesoft. So this is a particular listener. We are saying that you are a listener. Yes, you are a listener. But this particular person is saying, so if you take the example again of that particular excuse book what you have taken. This is saying that these all are saying that yes, we are listeners, but tell me when and how we need to listen, in which particular identity or in which particular element or in which particular API call we need to respond. So this is how we are defining here. So if you see that we are defining here which particular endpoint this particular listener needs to respond. So if you go to here advanced, here you will see that what particular methods we can provide here. So we are just providing here a get, so that we are saying that you are in get. So now what we are going to do is we are going to just display a simple message. So we will be using a component called set payload. What this this component does it, whatever the output you are, whatever the input you are getting, whatever the input you are getting from the source, you can change that particular payload. So we are just giving here . So if you see, we are just putting a static message here, congratulations, you have developed your first API application using Mule. So now what we are going to do is, this is a very simple project and we have developed this. So to run this project, what you need to do is, just right click here on the canvas and click on run project and whatever the project name is, you have opened the canvas for a project. So just select that. And everything is inbuilt under this Mule server. We don't need to get any kind of server, and it will automatically look for a Java, look for a JDK, and look for a Java runtime machine. If everything is there, it will deploy our project successfully to our on-premise, to our local system. So we are getting some error. Click on yes, and we will see how quickly we are able to develop the project and how quickly we are able to deploy that project to the local system. So here if you see that we are getting for a Java virtual machine, and now we are able to see that we are running in a testing mode. Mule is running in a testing mode. That means our application is being deployed to the local host. Once we will deploy that application, we can hit that particular URL from our browser, or we can also use some API testing tool. So we have, I already have API testing tool that is called as Postman. So I'll be using this, and you can also use browser for get method only. But in case of we are talking about post method, we have to use API testing tool so that we can get. So let's minimize this. This Mulesoft. So you can see our project name, whatever the domain is default, and the status is deployed. That means we have successfully deployed our project to the local host, to the on-premise server. So now let's go to our first we will go to browser and we will test that. So we provided localhost 8081, and then the listener that we provided, if you hit here, you will see that no listener for endpoint. Why we are not able to get? Because we didn't provide any listener for endpoint. Now if you provide here, you will say that Mulesoft, because we provided, we defined that this is a endpoint that you need to listen. So if you see, we are getting that message, whatever message that we have put there. Now if you wanted to test this, because whenever we are hitting any URL in the browser, that means it is making get request. It is saying that yes, tell me, give me this particular resource, whatever the URL I am hitting. Now let's say that we wanted to call this API with the help of API testing tool. So you need to download, or you can use some other Google Chrome extension, what you wanted to. So here what you need to do is, if you see that here we have different methods, we can select get, we can select post, we can select whatever the method we wanted to. So now let's put that here, click on send and see if you are able to get that particular message or not. So this is a very simple. Now let's go back to our project. stop our application, and now we are going to add one more listener here. So we will just, so why we are doing this? We just did it for get method, now we will do it for post method. So we will select whatever the listener we have created, and here we will also use the same endpoint because we wanted to post the data to the same endpoint. And in case of process, what process we wanted to, so we will use same thing, we will say that set payload, and here instead of payload what we are going to do is we are going to say that you are in post method. So after that we are again going to deploy our project, and then we will test that application with the help of API testing tool. So if you see here under this bottom right, we are getting some percentage, how many percentage our project has been built, what particular part is, how many part we have able to build the project, and how many part. And even here, if you are not getting some connectors, you can just click on search in exchange, and once you click on search in exchange, it will open a pop-up, and here you can search a particular thing. Let's say that if you wanted to search for AWS, you can just put AWS here and hit enter, so you will see what all connectors are available, and you can just click on add, finish. So all these connectors will be installed here, and you will get those connectors here. So let's start the project again, and then after we will test this post call as well. Post and get post call we will test again. So you can see it is already deployed. So let's open our postman, and now in this case of post, we will just click on send and see what we are able to get as an output here. So if you see that we are able to get you are in post method. And in case of post method, we can also provide a body to a particular URL. So let's say that here, if you are trying to provide, let's say that we are trying to provide here blog name. I'm saying it as SFDC Panther, SFDC Monkey, SFDC Panda. And you can also click on send, and you will get the same response. Now what if you wanted to see the same response as an output, because we are sending some data to the URL, we are sending the data to the URL saying that this particular, we are sending this data. So what you need to do is you just need to go to your application, deploy this, and what we will do is we will just, instead of set payload, we will here if you see in the function there is a thing called payload. So if you remember while we are discussing about our Mule event and Mule messages, we discussed about that payload and Mule event is contains of variables and Mule message, and Mule message contains payload and attributes. So payload is whatever we are sending, whatever we are getting from the resource, that will be a payload. So if you say that we can add here more event processor, and whatever the outcome will be for that particular process, preprocessor before this payload, that will be a, before this component, that will be a payload. So let's, for example, let's say that we are putting here some Salesforce create. I'm just putting here Salesforce create. So whatever the outcome for this particular component will be, it will also be a it will be a payload as well. So whatever the data we are getting from the previous component, that will be a payload. So here we are getting a payload. So and now let's again this deploy this project and see now what output we are able to get. Is running the project. So if you notice that, you can see that how quickly we can create the application with the help of Mulesoft, and we can give this particular, we can deploy this application to the cloud as well, and you can give the URL to the user, say that this is a particular endpoint that you have to hit for the testing purpose, and then after testing you can distribute the URL to your customers, to your users, to your partners, whom you wanted to distribute. So you see that we have deployed here. So now if you go open our Postman and click on send, we should be able to get whatever we are sending here from. So let's say that we are sending here Salesforce blogs, and you will click on send, you can get whatever we are getting from there. So this is how you can create a very basic simple application with the help of Mulesoft Anypoint Studio. And our next tutorial, we will see how we can deploy our local project to the cloud, how we can deploy to the project to the cloud server, and then how we can communicate cloud to cloud, because this is a local to cloud, and we will see how we can communicate cloud to cloud. So this is it for this session. If you have any questions or if you have any doubts, please come up in the comment section of this video. Thank you guys, we will see you on next video.